I'm very happy to be at this HyWe conference. And this conclave was really very contemporaneous, most relevant.
Very interesting. I think it's a brave effort to actually bring this out into the forum.
So overall, I think I just had a blast. Last 2 hours was awesome. I think you put people in that room and you put that energy and talk about happiness as a theme. Just love it.
So I think it's a phenomenal movement that Mukund has started. And it's heartening to find a whole room full of people who endorse it and who are supportive of this movement.
Fundamentally, when Mukund invited me, I actually wanted to know what it was all about. And the passion that he spoke with, the feeling with which he spoke with on the subject indicated to me that here is a genuine person who is really a passionista as far as the HyWe workplace is concerned.
But the most important thing is really the fact that there is an event that is giving a focus to something whose time has come. Probably a little too late, but even then I think Mukund has done a fantastic job in terms of bringing to consciousness a concept that needs to be incorporated across organizations.
And in today's world, where all life, all workplaces are reeking with stress and a veiled threat on the job, these kind of programs and thinking is most relevant.
It's important for people to realize that there's an alternate way to actually work, and you can be happy at work. And there's so much that can actually make you happy at the workplace, depending on how circumstances and everything works around you and how the company actually treats you.
A recent study of University of Warwick indicated that the happiness at workplace led to a 12% increase in productivity.
As long as you practice a way where people are allowed to take accountability, come up with plans and jobs to execute a job to get to the objective of the business, people will actually be more responsible than you think.
So I think it's largely a function of some very basic stuff. It doesn't seem like rocket science, but that's where organizations fail to some extent because they're not able to create that culture.
For the first time in history, 5 generations battling it out with each other. Companies also need to understand that because you have such a different subset of people, the desires of the millennials, like I pointed out, the desires of the older people, they vary. Definitely, you should not have unhappy employees. I think happiness is an ambiguous word that means different things to different people at levels of maturity and financial satisfaction.
So I think it's something very basic, right? So people are happy when they are treated with respect, when they know where they are headed in terms of their careers. Right?
For any organization, it is very important that they respect their employees. The employees can increase their productivity if they work fearlessly.
Flexibility is more important than remuneration benefits. If somebody has to work 60 hours to earn 5,000, they're happy to take less by having more time with their family. So when we give people that flexibility, if their child is sick, they take time off. After they come back to work, we realize that people are more into their job than ever. And that's how my business grows globally. We don't necessarily need to meet somebody. We don't necessarily have to monitor people's movement every 1 hour.
Ultimately, if people are looking at clean workplaces, ethical workplaces, certain amount of tolerance, respect, dignity, if you can at least offer that entire bundle, along with a few more tailor-made, customized options for them that make them happy, I think all in all, you would have a happy workforce working for you.
If people have a vision, a leader has a vision, people are willing to follow them to the ends of the earth, no matter whether you give me birthday gifts or not.
If you have to build a great corporate, first thing is a leader should have a good vision, and he has to delegate the things believing their people. What was I learned from this, and it was a good program.
But you should aim definitely to have employees who have visibility over what's happening. So you should be a transparent organization. You need to have them satisfied, engaged and enthusiastic. I think if you can achieve even that much, you are pretty much 90% on the way to being a perfect organization.
I think there are several takeaways for me. I really like the session, which was around how you create your self-brand, how you essentially are creator of your own destiny, how you control your happiness, right? And that's something that I took as a big takeaway.
And it is incumbent on people like us to take this message upwards and also spread within the whole organization.
And I'm glad Mukund has actually taken the first step and he's trying to drive this point home.
When would we have the concept of a chief happiness officer whose job is really nothing else but to ensure that people are really happy? Because I do believe that it needs focused attention.
idea is not to work for an organization, idea is to work with an organization.
Do the jobs that they're passionate about and not do a job because somebody told you that is a full job or you need to do it.
Right, it's a rat race. If you're a rat, if you choose not to be a rat, it's not a rat race anymore.